Very good morning, my dear students. So in this PPT, I'm going to explain you what are the different types of emission which we release from the vehicle. Okay, now that is called as engine. Topic is engine emission. Okay, so nowadays in a higher, that is the metro cities, so many vehicles are going day by day. Vehicle population is very high. So due to this, from the vehicle a very bad amount of gas, or that is a blow by gases, harmful gases which will be released from the vehicles, and that harmful gases will be combined with the environment. Due to this, from the humanity or the persons everywhere, the human, that is the human people, will take the breath. Due to that, health, it will affect the health. Okay, now by taking the breathing of that harmful gases from the vehicle, it will affect, and it will make chances of becoming a cancer or etc. any health problem. Okay, so to reduce that, so this is a systematic to the central government has decided to control the vehicles, and nowadays they are using some. There new systems are coming, like to control the harmful gases, like there is positive cavity ventilation system and the exhaust gas ventilation system, EGR system, okay, now catalytic converter, the etc. These are the system which will be adapted in the vehicle. Okay, and also we have to do day by day, that is emission testing also every month or every 15 days. If you are not doing emission test, means again they will catch you, your vehicle, they will what you can say, they will take that your vehicles in the station, they will they will charge some penalty. Okay, so to do this, I'm going to explain this engine emission. Okay, so engine emission can be divided into two subs, that is exhaust emission and non-exhaust emission. Okay, so exhaust emission means the unburnt hydrocarbon, that is HC, and oxide of carbon, that is CO2 and CO, hydrocarbon, hydrogen monoxide, nitrogen oxide, okay, SO2, SO3, and particulate smoke. These are the bad gases, that is the harmful gases will be released from the vehicle. So this will come under exhaust emission. Okay, first four are the common to the both SI and CI engine, and the last are mainly from the CI engine, that is a diesel engine. Okay, so normally almost all the vehicle will produce the this waste gases, that is a blowback gases. Okay, so these are called as exhaust emission. Okay, so hydrocarbon emission. So if the vehicle will release the hydrocarbon from the vehicle, what going to cause? Okay, so first cause is due to the incompletion of combustion. Okay, so in a cylinder, in a SI engine, in a cylinder, due to high pressure, some amount of fuel will not burn. Okay, that unfueled burnt will release into the environment. So that is the one first case, that is incomplete combustion takes place, that is proper combustion is not takes place. So next one is crevice volume and the flow in crevices. Okay, so flow of fuel is not proper. Okay, leakage past the exhaust valve. Okay, in between, that is the piston and cylinder, there is a chance of leakaging the waste gases. Okay, valve overlap, suppose if the valve is not fixed properly, there is overlap, there is a chances of releasing gases and deposit on a valve, and after it will deposit around the that is inner cylinder and near the piston rings. Okay, so this is about the hydrocarbon emission. Next, carbon monoxide emission, CO. So it will generate only when it will created when the engine is operated with a fuel rich equivalence ratio. So we have to run the vehicle with equal proportional fuel. But even if you are running with a high speed, that is a created with a high rich fuel ratio, then if there is a chance of releasing this carbon monoxide, that is what I wrote in the equation, CO plus half of oxygen, that is it will give the oxygen carbon mono, that is carbon hydroxide plus heat. Okay, carbon CO2 plus heat. Okay, so third one is the oxide of nitrogen. It will be causes also to be developed due to the created, it will create mostly from the nitrogen in the air, and second one is found in the fuel blend, so it will come through fuel only, and fuel may contain a trace amount of that is ammonia, NH3, NC and HCN. Okay, so these are the waste gases which will reduce from the oxide. Okay, so in this, again the primary cause for the photochemical smoke, due to smoke also, if you are not using proper fuel, there is a chance of releasing a smoke. Okay, that is what the equation, nitrogen oxide plus energy from the sunlight is equal to, it is a nitrogen plus oxygen plus smoke will be reduced. Okay, the minor emission is, that is aldehyde, sulfur and lead, phosphorus, these are the waste gases. Okay, emission control method. So how to control these type of blowback gases from the vehicle? There is a we have some devices that by using that we have to reduce those such waste gases from the vehicle. Okay, first one is, that is a thermal converter. It means to lower the emission. By using this thermal converter, we have to reduce the lower the emission. Okay, and we are and by using this converter we are doing the very high temperature chamber through which the exhaust gas flow, okay na. So by using this we can generate very high temperature can be through from the exhaust gases and promote the oxidation of the carbon monoxide and hydrocarbon which remains in the exhaust gases. So first one is not using too much, but second one, that is the second component, the catalytic converter, we are using almost all the modern vehicle, okay na. So the main function of this catalytic converter is to reduce the harmful gases into harmless gases, okay na. So that is a main use of this, okay. So not only this catalytic converter and the main okay, catalytic converter is the waste, that is it will the it with the conversion of harmful gases into harmless gases, that is called as in a catalytic converter. So the block diagram of catalytic converter is like this. So first the one side is connected with engine and one more side is connected with this exhaust gases, okay. So here in the it will in the catalytic converter it consists of two part, that is it is like a two filter. So first one is that is a reduction and oxidation, okay. So here I shown, okay, not there. In the catalytic converter we have the two parts, okay. First one is a reduction and oxidation. In oxidation in the oxidation filter we have by some platinum, and reduction catalyst we have some rhodium component, okay. So from the engine, that is when engine is started, from the engine there is a bad amount of gases will become, that is hydrocarbon and CO, that will enter into the catalytic converter devices. There they will reduce the harmful gases and it will enter into the oxidation. In oxidation oxygen will mix up with, then hydrocarbon and water can be expelled out from this device, that can be easily expelled to the atmosphere, okay na. So that is the main function of this catalytic converter. I wrote here same, that is a, it is a automatic catalytic converter are made up of platinum and palladium and rhodium or a combination of these materials, okay. The platinum and palladium are used to change the hydrocarbon and carbon oxide into CO2 and water, okay. The main function of these two are to change the unburned gases, and they will add the oxygen, they will reduce into the carbon oxide and water, okay na. So here platinum palladium will be fixed in the catalytic converter devices, okay. And rhodium acts as a reduce the nitrogen oxide emission, okay. So the rhodium, the main function of rhodium in the catalytic converter device is to reduce the NOx emission, okay. Due to enhanced emission standard, later model catalytic converter now used in a cerium to attract the and release the oxygen inside the converter to aid in the process of changing the hydrocarbon and carbon oxide, okay, to the exhaust gases, okay. Here I note, so what is mean by catalytic converter means that it is a agent or it is a device inside the catalytic converter, either in ceramic beads or a honeycomb shaped blocks will be there. So all catalytic converter are encased in the stainless steel housing, okay na. So this is the definition of this. Otherwise you can write definition is the main function of catalytic converter is to reduce the harmfulness gases into harmless gases, okay. So what are the problems related with catalytic converter? So I told, no, same here, some unburned gases will be, they will reduce, and here the reduction and oxidation will be there. In the reduction component it will reduce the it will reduce the harmful gases, then it will go into the, it is oxidation process. In oxidation process there is oxygen will be added, so that will reduce the hydrocarbon, that is water, in expelled out into the atmospheric. So okay na. So here the cold startups also there. So if it is not efficient when the engine are cooled, okay na. So when the engine, that is the vehicle engine, is cooled, it will not work properly, okay. After engine started, it takes several minutes to become efficient. As you know, some engines, when in the rainy season, some vehicles, even if two wheeler also, sometime it will not work out, okay na. So because of cold and because of cold environment, or it will be moisture. So sometime this during that time catalytic converter will not use properly, okay na. Not it will not work effectively. So non exhaust emission, okay. Not only that, is this all are component, those all are number exhaust, non exhaust emission means source in the automobile which emit the emission from fuel tank, carburetor, crankcase, okay na. These are the comes under non exhaust emission. Not only from the fuel, it will released from the fuel tank also, carburetor also, crankcase also, na. So modern air operator emission control system, here the block diagram I shown here. okay now. So this system will be fixed to the vehicle. Okay, so crankcase blow by. So what is the crankcase blow by? Means the blow by is the phenomenon of leakage past the piston and the piston rings from the cylinder to the crankcase. Okay, I told now earlier also, when due to high pressure combustion takes place, but due to combustion there is a unburnt fuel gas will be there, remains in the piston and the piston rings. Okay, so the blow by HC emission are about 20% of the total hydrocarbon emission from the engine. So this is increased to about 35% if the engines are, if the rings are worn. Okay, so it will automatically, it will increase, but proper fixing of the piston rings in the cylinder. Okay, so this is about the catalytic converter functions. Okay, now so exhaust gases and non-exhaust emission. I think I hope you understand this. In this, just to remember that what is meant by catalytic converter and how it will work. That's it. Okay, so I hope you understand this. Thank you.